Welcome to the physics class. This is the chain pendulum with its stopper. The chain pendulum with its stopper. This is a Galileo experiment. As we have been discussed on the previous lessons concerning with the Galileo experiment with a simple pendulum with its stopper. So instead of using a string, here we are using a chain of paper clips. A single clip is like this one. This is a single clip. So, a number of paper clips making up a chain like this one. This is a chain. It is a chain of paper clips. So then, a chain of paper clips is attached with a pendulum bob at the end. Then, it is suspended to a small angle, then released. It is moving to and fro. In this case, the pendulum is moving perpendicular to the stopper. It's moving perpendicular to the stopper. So it can stop for some time, then it starts moving again. So in this experiment, we are going to use the formula for the periodic time t. For the periodic time t, it was like this one. A periodic time t, it was is equal to negative pi squared over g l over t. But in this case, we are using the number of paper clips plus 2 pi under root of l over g. So here it is negative pi squared over g m L over T plus 2 pi under root of L sub T dividing by G. L sub T is the total length of a pendulum. It is the total length of a pendulum, whereby L is the length of a single paper clip. T is the periodic time. So this formula can be used if the distance between the suspension point and the stopper is decreased, this distance. If we can decrease the distance from the stopper, from the suspension point to the stopper, this formula can be used. So if the distance is increased from the stopper, to the suspension point, the formula could be the same as this one, but without a negative number here. A negative sign, sorry. So the formula can be used in this way, pi squared over g, n l over t, plus 2 pi under root of l sub t divided by g. So this formula can be used when the distance from the stopper to the suspension point is increased. So we are considering this equation. So from this equation, if we take this part of this one, as we have discussed on the simple pendulum with its stopper, tulisema kwamba pendulum ikimove namna hii, then it can stop. Kwamba tukasema kwamba angular velocity, it is a half of the total angular velocity. So then, tukaendelea tukapata hii formula. This is the periodic time for the half of the motion. But for the total motion of the pendulum, it is given by the 2 pi L over G. So then, the effective periodic time was this one. So if we consider this part only, a part of the half angular velocity, it will be like this one. T is equal to pi squared over g n l over t. So make it T as collect the right terms. T here, there is a T here. So T squared is equal to pi squared n l over g. Pi squared n l over g. So then, if we I can remove this square on the T here by putting the radical on both sides. Here it could be the under root of T squared is equal to the under root of pi squared N L over G. So here it will be equal to this one. T is equal to pi out of the square root under root of L over G multiplying by the under root of N. So this is the periodic time. So to keep it in the general formula there for the Galileo experiment, it could be T now could be equal to pi under root of L over G under root of N plus 2 pi under root of L total dividing by G. So in this case, always we are varying the time for n number of oscillations. N number of oscillations is obtained by varying the number of n, the number of paper clips. By number of the paper clips is changing by the changing of time. So the periodic time is affected only by the number of paper clips, whereby L is the length of a single paper clip, which is constant, G is constant, pi is constant, also length of a pendulum is constant. So then our formula becomes this one. So if pi over T, if here pi under root of L over G to be equal to P, and this 2 pi under root of L sub T over G, if we call it, is equal to Q. So then, the formula will be equal to, the formula for the periodic time could be equal to, T is equal to, this is P under root of N plus Q. So this is how the periodic time T relates to the number of paper clips. The periodic time T is directly proportional to the number under root of the number of the paper clips, where P and Q are the constants. So here, if we can compare with the Y is equal to MX plus C, this is Y, this is slope M, this is the X, and this is C, which is the intersect of the graph. So the graph of it is a straight line with the Y intercept and a positive slope. Okay. Nikukaribisha tu katika video inayofuata ili tuweze kufanya hii experiment na kutafuta maswali na kufanya maswali yanayojili kutokana na hii experiment. Usisahau subscribe, share or like. Asante.